tell the story, so to him it does belong. But I wrap the tune around it, put a tell it in a song. It's a tale about three bushmen prospecting for gold, and the saga of the loaded dog as Henry Lawson told. They had heard about a reef of gold out near Stony Creek, and so they sank a shot and struck hard rock at 7 feet. They had pitched a tent and made their camp in a patch of scrub, and Dave and Jim were down the shaft while Andy cooked some grub. They drilled the rock and blasted it, progress was hard and slow, still they persisted with the patience gold prospectors know. Dave Regan, he loved fishing, and Andy faced it too, but now that it was winter, they were catching very few. So Dave suggested they blow up the big hole down the creek and trade what fish they didn't want to the butcher for some beef. So Andy cooked some spuds for lunch and put the billy on, and while the chops were frying, started making up a bomb. With miners blasting powder wrapped up in calico, then tightly rolled in sailcloth with whipcord then was sewed. A 6-foot fuse inserted with the end split for to light, the bomb was dipped in tallow then to make it watertight. They had a big retriever pup with a permanent foolish grin, and no matter what they threw away, he'd fetch it back again. He watched where Andy hit the bomb away from everyone, and when Dave and Jim came up for lunch, the dog began his fun. He had the cartridge in his mouth as round the fire he came, the fuse began to hiss and spit when the end fell in the flame. Well, the three men bolted different ways through the bracken fern, while Tommy thought it was a game and chased each one in turn. Jim shinned up a sapling, Tommy waded underneath, a silly grin across his face with a bomb between his teeth. The fuse was getting shorter, so Jim sprang from the tree and bolted for the pub while Tommy chased him playfully. He charged into the barroom and quickly slammed the door. When Tommy couldn't get inside, he went under the floor. A savage yellow cattle dog was waiting underneath. He wanted what that big pup had, it might be good to eat. The cattle dog, he chased him out and bit him really hard. So Tommy dropped the cartridge there in the hotel yard. The yellow dog stood over, sniffed it up and down. Then suddenly the bomb went off and rocked that little town. Some saddle horses broke their reins and galloped down the street, and pieces of that cattle dog were blown 500 feet. Well, Dave and Jim and Andy went quietly to their tent, while Tommy grinned his broadest grin, pleased with the day's event. What could have been disaster in the pub at Stony Creek turned out to be a thing the bush folk laughed about for weeks. And travelers heard the story, and the story got around, the story of a loaded dog that terrorized a town.